When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care and nothing's going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there. If the sky above you grows dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind begins to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud. Soon you'll hear me knocking at your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Now ain't it good to know.
Greetings, everyone.
Happy Halloween.
Trick or treat. The trick will be for you to find the truth in today. The treat will be, it will be everywhere. So with that, hope your day was fun, or is fun, or will be fun, whatever you decide to do today, if you get to go to a party tonight or already went. Well, I hope it was something different, because you sure don't want to be whoever you are in this life. It's always, let's pretend we're somebody else. And whoever or whatever that is, hopefully gave you a cheap thrill. Halloween has become just as important for the adults as it has and was for children. I mean, the idea to make up, get dressed up, become anything, or be anything you want to be, or dream or fantasize about, and go out to the world and pretend you're that for a day. Imagine it was every once a week, once a month. I mean, even that would be pretty hardcore. But you know, crime happens a lot because people are wearing masks. So right away, it becomes a violent thing. And luckily, it's getting big, because they were from poisoning candies, killing children, and all kinds of horrible things. So it goes up and down. I mean, if we can keep this without major problems happening today, I'll be really happy. Because all we have to hear is a clown did something, or Superman did, or anybody, any superhero, whatever. Well, it's one of those days. It's called trick or treat. And too many people like to trick rather than treat. Or don't have the money to treat, so they have to trick them. So, before I go any further, today I'm just saying a reminder out there. TJ's being at the hospital all the time. Her daughter's in serious condition. Anybody that can send any kind of help to her, in prayers, please do, to her and her family. If you got a couple extra dollars, pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters, whatever you got, and you have a little bit to donate, send it to PayPal, TJ Morris Agency, AGENCY, at gmail.com. I'm sure she's going to need every penny to get through this. She had her two daughters living with her. Now the one's in the hospital. So it's a really super big burden when anybody is in critical condition. It's a serious burden. It doesn't get better too easy. So please, anybody out there, that was TJ. Thank you her for her singing. I always play it because it makes me feel like she still helped me doing the show, a part of it. All right. Today's going to be so hardcore, and I mean that. I'm going to try to get through this as fast as I can. If you got an important question, please call in, and I'll get to it. But try to follow. This is going to go a lot of different directions. I don't care what religion you are, what belief you have. I don't care, whatever. Stay here. Don't run away. Don't go run and hide. Don't panic. And don't say, well, this is a religious thing. No, it's about where we went wrong in religion, spiritualism, and life. And we're going to go into those words. I'm taking the kids' gloves off. Most speakers out there have to put them on when they talk. They don't want to talk too hard, too real. I don't want to scare their people that are paying them away. I don't care. You're going to run, you're going to run. But if you've got a little bit of courage in your body, stay, stick around, and listen. It's not going to be all pleasurable. Not at all. It's the truth. The truth of what went wrong, where it went wrong, and why it keeps going wrong. So, I can't test this. I hope the sounds are right. Anybody could text me, go into the chat room, call in, just to say that if you can. I did a show last week. I talked for 45 minutes, and it was dead. So, with that being said, I sure hope you're hearing me today. Okay, we got two words that I'm using. Prejudiced and judgment, which will be part of everything I talk about today in some form, some way. But two more words added rather recently in our history that make it 10 times harder for us to move forward. The one word is freedom, F-R-E-E-D-O-M, and the three-letter word, S-E-X. So, yeah, these four words are the downfall for the human race, alien races, everything. It's the complete downfall of reality as we know it. Just four words. How's that? Well, stay here. Listen in today. Tell your friends, call them up, tell them to get in, get on, and tune in. It's recorded, so they can pull it up tonight, tomorrow, finish their Halloween off. I'm not into deceitful or deceiving, brainwashing, programming people. Let those people out there making money off of it do it. They like doing it because they get money doing it, and they're happy. Well, that's their problem. Now, the first thing I'm going to say, everybody out there, including you, are a hypocrite. Okay, the word prejudice, we can tear it apart. It's within every one of you out there. Oh, I'm not prejudiced. Oh, yes, you are. Just because you don't say it, just because you don't admit it, doesn't mean you're not. The definition, I mean, it's a preconceived opinion that is not based on actual or real experience. But what if it is? Can you use prejudice the same way? What if it's based on actual experiences? Can you say, well, oh, that's prejudiced? If you lived in a community and say you were the only black person or the only white person, and all you saw every day was everybody beating each other up, killing each other, could you be prejudiced? Is that enough experience to say, well, I'm not basing this on somebody, what somebody else said. I see it. I'm a part of it. Well, it becomes real. And it's not make-believe. And it's not a word that should just be erased out of your vocabulary. You need to be prejudiced. and that other word that goes alongside it, which I use, and people say, well, no, they're the same. Judgment. When you make a judgment on something, you're judging it on your experiences or whatever information you have, pertaining you do have some. You can't make a judgment without any proof. And that's guessing. It's not judgment. Judgment means, well, I saw them do this and I saw them do that. I mean, with awareness and actual experience. Being afraid to judge something, really, why? You're considered different if you claim to be a judgmental person. But if you are not a judgmental person, you are stuck in the world of control. You're the fool. The fool that listens. The fool that does because they say, well, this is right, that's right. You don't know. You don't know. Yes, you do. Or you should. And if you don't find the truth yourself. But now, here's something that you will not hear people talk about. I get into every aspect of it because I put this through every level of awareness that I have. Do you know you can break everything down? All these words into a couple more words that pertain to the body. All right? Get a pencil and paper. Write them down, just so you know what they are, in case you don't hear me say it. The first word is smell. S-M-E-L-L. Smell. Well, that smells bad. That smells good. That smells incredible. All right? Taste. Oh, that tastes good. That tastes bad. Then the word that's a little bit outside of that is looks, L-O-O-K-S. Oh, that looks pretty. Oh, that looks stupid. That looks disgusting. All right. Then the last one, feelings inside the body. You're with somebody. Oh, I feel good. Oh, I feel bad. I don't feel right. I feel sick. Okay, those words make you judgmental. They make you prejudiced. If somebody smells bad all the time, you're going to judge that. By a smell. I mean, these words are affected by those aspects of what we are. Smell, taste, looks, and feelings. Not black, red, yellow, green, purple. Yeah, they can cause the way you look at things, but it's not really that. You were told black, you were told red, you were told green, you were told things about colors. And then, if you don't have the experience, you compare it to something else that you don't even know, or that's not even there. Well, red has to do with Lucifer. Compare it to that. How? How come? Why? Why would you accept somebody who said, well, red is the color of the devil? It's acceptance of ridiculous ideas. So, the word prejudice and judgment go together. And they're all affected by those four things. Remember that. That's very important. I don't think anybody ever brought it out. And it needs to be. That your taste buds, your smell, and the way you perceive things, meaning the way things look. And if somebody wears a short dress, and girls wear a short dress, and you always told her that's bad, you look at that and say it's bad. Or if somebody's wearing a long dress, well, they're outdated. You're programmed by thoughts that were conditioned within to you. But it's those things that bring it out. And feelings are really never right. They seem right in the moment. They go up and down super fast. Go on a roller coaster, they go up and down. So do your feelings. Go in a dark room, in a fun house. I mean, those things change you instantly. But when you come out, you're still the same person. Nothing changed. Everything's still the same. So, we have to become aware of what we allow to program us. And sadly to say, there's nothing good programming us to anything good. Except me. Well, that you might perceive as a lie as well, but that is your choice. I will try to get into all this the best I can today, and I'm going to try to move as fast.